Out of all the letters in acronym LGBTQ+, the L was the first one to came into existence. For centuries, the word has been associated with the works of Sappho, an ancient Greek woman from the island of Lesbos, who wrote poems about same-gender passion in 600 BC. Sappho was an intellectual and poet who wrote many love poems to other women. Much of her poetry that has been destroyed by religious fundamentalists, and the few poems of Sappho that remain speak clearly to her love and infatuation with women. So, how did Sappho become the source of word to how to describe the female homosexuality? The reason that Sappho has become so closely associated with other female homosexuality is due to the only of her many poetic works that has been survived in its eternity. The so-called Ode to Aphrodite is a lyric poem in which the speaker calls on Aphrodite, the goddess of love, for help in pursuit of her beloved. Until the 19th century, the sex of this individual has been translated as being male. However, in 1835, it was discovered that the object of Sappho's love in the ode was actually female due to the mistranslation of a single word. During the same period, scholars, scientists, and doctors began to examine the somewhat neglected in comparison to the phenomena of male homosexuality, the field of female homosexuality. This coincided with the increasing popular new theory of Sappho's sexual orientation. It was only natural, therefore, that when searching for a term to describe female homosexuality, one is drawn to the individual who at the time might be considered the original. Despite the use of gay as an umbrella term for gender and sexual minorities, it is only from the mid to the late 20th century, and thanks to the advent of the women's movement, that the term lesbian grew in popularity and was adopted by women who secretly, then proudly, loved each other.